What's up, guys? Today I'm going to be showing you the beginning of making my own overfenders for the drift truck, since no one makes any. Hanneman makes a set of bed sides for these, but they just look super funky. If you want to check out their website, if you're interested, the Hanneman ones, they just kind of, they're flat and then they just like bump out like super square and then go across the wheel and then back in. It looks kind of like a dually flare. It's kind of weird, but anyways, I just started with masking everything off and then laying expanding foam over that. I'm going to go ahead and shape it with these file, not these files, but like these rasps. And then from there, I'll coat it with like a drywall putty, since it's super easy to sand and it's a lot cheaper than using body filler. And then once I have it pretty close with the drywall putty, then I'll go over it with body filler. And then there's a few other steps, but we'll talk about that when we get there. So for now, enjoy a montage. Alright, so got most of a basic shape sort of roughed in. I need to add some more foam in some places and then go back after it with the rasp again. And the D21s, they have kind of a rectangle wheel opening, so I want to keep that so it's the same as the front. So I need to add some shit in down there and keep going. What are you doing, Bill?
Harmonic balancer on this 2002 Chevy Impala. 3.4 liter.
How much you picked that up for?
300 bones.
$300, little man. It's a nice
127,000 miles.
Nice car for 300 bones.
Yeah.
Shit. It's a nice little daily. So yeah, more on this shit. Bye. Basic shape of the overfender's all done. It's still in pretty rough form, but it's pretty close and it looks pretty damn good from the back. Look at all that tire under there. Looks pretty good. Now, next step, I'm gonna use drywall putty and kind of mud the whole thing in and get rid of like all the big cavities and shit like that. I'm using drywall putty because if I were to do it with body filler, it'd be like over $100 in body filler. Instead, I'm just going to spend, you know, $20 on drywall putty, and it sands a lot easier too. So do a time lapse of applying that stuff for you. Sweet.
What we do here is go back.
Oh,
So this is where I'll stop for the night. Looks pretty good, pretty wide, almost like a dually fender almost. But this stuff says it takes 1 to 5 hours to dry. It's been 2 hours. It dries white, so it looks like it still has a ways to go. So I'm just gonna come back tomorrow and start sanding on this. But looks pretty good. Let me know what you guys think. There, this video will be probably a 2 or 3 part video. This is obviously part one. Part two, I don't know when I'll have a chance to really work on this thing again. Also, the other day I did my aluminum roof skin that I've been meaning to do. Turned out pretty good. It's much lighter than the steel one. And then put on my hood vent. A lot of people just cut these things square with like a cutoff wheel, and I think that looks kind of cheesy, so I used a hole saw, or a unibit actually, and drilled it so all the edges are radiused. I think it looks a little bit better, a little cleaner, and it's different too, so I'm all about being different. Also, installed my rear view mirror. You guys can't really see it in my steering wheel hook. So yeah, interior's looking very race car now. Sorry it's dark in here, but stay tuned for part two. Peace.